Clip Studio Paint's most amazing features are vector layers. In this tutorial, I want to look at how they will be able to help you perfect your line art. What's a vector layer? If you've never heard of the term before, you might wonder what the difference between a vector layer and a typical bitmap layer is. The best way to explain is to give a small demonstration. Let's start by drawing line art on both a bitmap and a vector layer. I've drawn a B for the bitmap layer and a V for the vector layer. I've drawn these letters very small, so now let's see what happens when we scale them up. Pay attention to the edges of the line art. You'll notice that the bitmap layer is looking pixely, whereas the vector layer is still looking sharp. That's because a bitmap layer saves pixels, and a vector layer saves the data for your strokes. Another way you can see the difference is if you use the object tool and select the line art. On a bitmap layer, you will see nothing. If you do the same on a vector layer, you will now see a bunch of little dots. These are the control points of the line you drew, and they can be moved around to adjust your line art after you've already drawn it. And that brings us to the actual meat of the tutorial. Perfecting your line art, method 1, adjusting the shape. I want to give a practical demonstration of these methods. So to start out, I've decided to sketch a little character that's going to illustrate the advantages of vector layers very clearly. I like to sketch on a bitmap layer so that any work I do on the line art vector layer won't be affected by the sketch. I also like to use a bright color for my sketches to differentiate it from the black line art I draw on top of it. If I draw multiple characters or backgrounds in detailed illustrations, I sometimes use different colors to separate different parts of the image. Here's an example. But back to our tutorial drawing, we have a very round head shape here. You've probably seen plenty of memes about how digital artists draw circles. They'll control C and redraw the circle a million times. But with a vector layer, you can adjust the line afterwards without quality loss, so you can just go with your first drawing. Let's take this circle here. It's not even fully closed. We're gonna adjust that now with the Pinch Vector Line tool. There's a variety of settings available here and I'll explain them in a bit. Right now, let's just find out how the tool works. As you can see, I was able to drag the end of my line around and make it a fully closed circle. Let's look at the settings of the tool in detail now. Most important is the pinch level setting. With it, you'll be able to adjust the strength of the tool. Remember how you saw all those control points when you selected your line art with the object tool? If you have your pinch level set to the lowest point, you'll basically just grab a single control point and move that around. On the other hand, if you have your pinch level set to the highest point, depending on the size of your line art and also your effect range setting, which is basically a brush size setting, you might move around the entire line art. So, choosing which pinch level to work with depends on what you want to achieve and what your line art already looks like. Just experiment with it. You can always undo a mistake. The fix end options specify whether the beginning and ending of a line will stay where they are. You can either leave both the beginning and end in the same place, only one of them, or neither of them. If you select the fix both ends option, you could drag around the line to make it look like you're using a jump rope, and I think that illustrates how the functionality works pretty well. The add control point option does exactly what it says. When you adjust your line art, it adds new control points. This can sometimes result in a smoother looking line. Finally, the connect lines option. It's pretty self-explanatory. I've already given an example of using the Pinch Vector Line tool to close a circle. With this option active, you could do the same, or connect two separate lines. The difference being is that it suddenly becomes one fully connected line, linking two control points together. It will only connect if you move two endpoints of one or two lines close to one another. Let's go back to our sketch and look at another way you can adjust the shape of your line art. The Pinch Vector Line tool is great, but if you want to adjust the overall shape of your line art, especially if there's already a lot of detail to your drawing, then you might want to use the Mesh Transformation tool instead. With mesh transformation, you now get a bunch of control points that you can adjust to inform the overall shape in a much quicker way. As you can see, I adjusted the circle to be more round, even though it's not going to look like a perfect mathematical circle either. I still want a hand-drawn look after all. If you'd like to go into more detail without resorting to the pinch vector line tool, you could also increase the amount of control points the mesh transformation tool will generate. To do so, simply increase the values in the tool settings here. Keep in mind that you can also use the mesh transformation tool on portions of your line art, not just the whole drawing. So, for example, you could select a portion with the lasso tool and then use the mesh transformation tool to adjust only the lassoed portion while leaving the rest of the line art intact. Sometimes when making these kinds of adjustments, you may notice weird spikes appear in your line art. This is a normal side effect of using vector layers. If you go back to the object tool and select your line, you should be able to identify where this problem arises. This usually is a control point that is located a bit outside of where it should be. Simply select that control point, move it around, and the spike should disappear again. Perfecting your line art, method 2. Using the vector eraser. Now that we have the base for the character's head done, we can move on to adding details. And this is where our next method comes in, the vector eraser. If you haven't used the tool before, you might be used to erasing lines in your drawings manually. This takes a while, and you sometimes might even overlook small bits of line art here and there. The vector eraser will help you deal with both of these issues. Before I'll show the tool's application in a practical way, I want to explain it in detail. To do so, I drew this grid. Think about how this is an intersection of multiple lines. The reason we're going to do this is because the main advantage the vector eraser has is that it can help you erase lines only up until their intersection. To activate this feature, switch to your eraser tool, activate the vector eraser option, and select the Erase up to intersection option. You can now see how this speeds up the erasing process compared to doing it normally, and once we go back to the practical application, you'll see me using this method a lot. Before we do that though, a quick explanation of the other two vector eraser options. Erase touched areas pretty much makes the vector eraser function like a normal eraser. Erase whole line does exactly that. I'm now going to show a time-lapse of the drawing being finished before I move on to the next method. What you might notice while watching is that I don't always use the pinch vector line tool. Sometimes I do just use undo and redraw until I'm happy with a line. None of these methods are laws that you'll need to follow at all times, but they are just ways to help you achieve an end result you're happy with. Here, I'm also straight up just copying an existing drawing and mirroring it. Don't be afraid to use methods like this if you want a symmetrical look for certain features. It's not cheating or being lazy, it's simply being effective in fully utilizing the tools you are given in digital art creation. If I'm going to add an element to my drawing where I already know I'll need to adjust it, it makes sense to create a new vector layer for it before drawing it. There's two advantages to this. First, if I erase sections of it, I'm only going to erase sections on that layer, and not anything below. So, I can make more sweeping gestures rather than any detailed adjustments, saving me time. Second, if I want to adjust the entire shape using the mesh transformation tool, I can also do that without having to worry about first using the lasso tool to select only that portion of the drawing. Perfecting your line art, method 3. Adjusting the weight. Now that the basic drawing is mostly done, there's only one problem left. It looks a bit flat. Using weight variances in line art can really help exaggerate or define shapes. Of course, if you plan on adding weight to your drawing by doing detailed shading or painting it, you might not need the variances in the line art itself. It's up to you to decide what kind of style you're going for. But for now, let's assume that we are doing a simple, flat-collared piece and that we do want the weight variances. It's not always easy to get this right when you first ink, so it's a good thing that with vector layers, we can go back in and adjust the line weight using the correct line width tool. There's a bunch of different settings available here again, so let's look at them in detail. Thicken and scale up width are pretty much the same option and make your line art look thicker. The main difference, as I found it to be, is that thicken uses the point value as you might find in a brush size, whereas scale up uses a percentage value based off of the line art you're applying the tool to. Narrow and scale down width are the exact inverse of the other two options and make your line art look thinner. Fixed width is different in that it helps you set a certain line art size and immediately adjust your drawing to that. This option will also remove all existing line weight variances. If you want a uniform line art width, this is going to be a very useful option for you. You can combine all of these methods with the process whole line option, which does exactly what you might assume it does. Rather than adjusting sections of a line that you might be applying the tool to, it applies the tool to the entire line. This ignores intersections, unlike the vector eraser. You can, of course, also adjust the brush size of this tool so that you can either work in detail or apply the settings to your entire drawing. An alternative way of adjusting the line weight of your drawing after it's done is by going back to the Object tool. Click and drag to select your entire drawing or whatever portion of the drawing you want to adjust. Now, you can adjust the base brush size value in the Tool Property window. This is a bit faster than using Thicken and Narrow over and over again, and compared to using Fixed Width, it retains the existing line weight variances. This is what the line art looked like once I adjusted the weight. You'll find that it isn't the most dramatic difference, and that's okay. It doesn't always need to be. Here's what I changed and why. I thickened the line weight of the hair and the hands to give them a bit more volume. I thinned out the line weight of the bottom of the head to connect it more to the body. I evened out the line weight of the arms to make it appear more unified. I thinned out the line weight of the clothing details to have them be less distracting from the character's silhouette. Perfecting your line art, method 4, coloring your line art. Next, we're going to be looking at adding color to your line art. There's multiple ways to do so. The first one we're going to look at is the layer color option, which you'll find in the layer property window under the effect section. This gives your entire layer a uniform color. You can either define this color by clicking in the color field, which opens a color picker, or you can apply your currently active color by clicking the fill bucket icon. What's interesting about this option is that it recognizes the brightness values of your line art. So if, for instance, you drew your line art in shades of gray, or maybe even in color, once you apply this option, your line art is now going to be uniformly colored, but in different shades of the color you picked. In drawing comics, I often use the layer color option, and I like giving a darker layer color to my characters and a brighter layer color to my backgrounds to make the characters pop more. However, if you want to color your line art in more detail, this option might not be the best for you. If you have very simple line art without a lot of strokes, then you could just go back in with the Object tool, select portions of your line art, open the main color option in the Tool Property window, manually select a color, and press OK. However, if you have a more complex line art, it might be easiest to just create a new layer above your line art layer and select the Clip to Layer Below option. I would recommend using a bitmap layer for this rather than a vector layer, as I personally find it easier to manage than two vector layers on top of each other. Once you've done this, anything you paint or draw on the top layer will only be visible where you've drawn line art on the bottom layer. You can deselect the Clip to Layer Below option again to find that whatever you've drawn on this layer actually does extend beyond the line art. It just doesn't show up, letting you color the line art. Keep in mind that you can activate the Clip to Layer Below option from multiple layers. so you could create different layers for different colors. This can be especially useful if you want to fine-tune the colors later on. Here's what the colored line art looked like once I finished it, with the flat colors below both deactivated and activated. Perfecting your line art method 5, adjusting the style. We've arrived at the last method for perfecting your line art. So let's say you finished this drawing, and you're actually pretty happy with it. But then, you come across a really neat brush and you realize, man, it would have been perfect for this drawing. Should you just redraw the whole thing now? With vector layers, you don't have to. Just like you can adjust the shape, weight, and color of your line art, you can also change the brush style. To do this, go back to the object tool and select your line art, or whichever portions of your line art you want to change. In the tool property window, look for the brush shape option. You can now select any of the following options and it will change your line art style. But there's a problem, the brush you just found isn't in this list. Fortunately, it's pretty easy to add a new shape. To do so, select your brush in the pen tool or whichever other tool you may have registered the brush to. Now click the little wrench icon in the tool property window. The subtool detail window will open. Here, select the brush shape menu. Finally, click register to preset. You may now close the window, and now the brush will be available in the object tool brush shape option. And just like that, you can very easily give your drawing a fresh new look. A note on pen stabilization. Before we close off this tutorial, I want to quickly address the stabilization feature. I often see people asking about this. Personally, I like to leave the setting pretty low, at around 6. I'm used to drawing fast, quick strokes, so this option works pretty well for me. But just experiment. If you find yourself drawing slow, long pen strokes and you're unsatisfied with the line art looking kind of wobbly, then a higher stabilization setting might work out better for you. The one disadvantage higher stabilization settings have is that they will feel less like your drawing and more like you're guiding around your line art, if that makes sense. The actual line art is going to follow your cursor at a distance so that the stabilization has time to catch up to what you're doing. Personally, not a fan of that, so I don't use this option, but it will definitely have its use for some people. And keep in mind that you can also adjust it, of course. No need to always stick to a single stabilization setting for your entire drawing. Maybe on one line you'll want the feature, maybe on another you won't. So my advice is to just experiment and find what works for you personally. And there we have it. 5 different methods to perfecting your line art using vector layers in Clip Studio Paint. You can use these independently of each other or combine them to create a variety of interesting art styles. I hope this helped, and if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments.